I do want to tell you that it is an honor for me to be here with Master of Ceremonies, because Aida and Richard have been such close friends for quite some time. So I thank you for allowing me to share your day with you, Aida. Thank you. And we, on behalf of everybody, we want to thank you for being here with us, because it is a special day. It's Aida's very special day, and we're here to honor her. After so many years that she has given to us, now we're here to help her celebrate this day. So thank you. And now I will start. We'll go ahead and get the program going. We will start with the presentation of the colors. This is by the PSJA North High School, JROTC. Would you please stand? And also remain standing for a national anthem after the colors. Carrying the U.S. flag is Cadet Evie Castro. Texas flag, Cadet Oziel Monarres. Raider Battalion flag, Cadet Paulina Bernal. Right guard, Cadet Francisco Reyes. Left guard, Cadet Carlos Gonzalez. And they're directed by Sergeant First Class Brandall. I'd like now to call on for the Pledge of Allegiance, a fifth grade student, Salvador Colunga.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now for the national anthem, I would like to call on fourth grade student, Gabriela Casares. Thank you, Gabriela. Beautiful voice. Now I'd like to call on fourth grade student Sofia Leal for the invocation.
Please bow your head. Heavenly Father, we call upon you to be present with us at this celebration. Bless all the students, teachers, administrators, parents, and guests. Bless the students with the desire to learn. Grant us the strength to be obedient to authority and to act properly with our friends and classmates. Bless the teachers with the skills to impart true knowledge and wisdom. Bless our administrators with the ability to lead our school toward excellence. Bless our parents with an understanding heart as we grow through the years. Bless all our guests with a patience, with the peace and joy that only you can give. Bless this school that it may be the center for sound learning and new discovery, so that all students may attain success in academics. Bless us with the gift of laughter that we may enjoy the life of childhood. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
And you may be seated now. I would like now to call on Ms. Diana Ruiz, the administrative assistant, administrator for elementary schools, for some acknowledgments.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this very special event. Welcome to this beautiful facility named in honor of a very special person, Mrs. Aida Escobar, one of PSJA's greatest educators. First of all, I would like to introduce her family, her husband, Mr. Richard Escobar. Please stand. And we all know Richard. Her daughter, Cindy Perales. Her granddaughters, Rina and Renee. Mrs. Escobar's pride and joy. Her son, Rick, and Mela Escobar. And her sister, Elena Leduras. And of course, other family members. Thank you for being here. In addition, I would like to recognize some dignitaries and community leaders that are here with us today. We have, first of all, our school board member, Ronaldo Rani Cantu, our vice president, Jesus Jesse Vela Jr., Secretary Treasurer Victor Perez, Member Humberto Bobby Rodriguez, in our superintendent's cabinet, we have Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources, Mr. Juan Alvarez, Assistant Superintendent for Student Services, Rene Ramirez, Senior staff present today, Administrator for College Readiness, Nelda Cantu. Administrator for High Schools, Dr. Nora Cantu. Administrator for Human Resources, Rebecca Garza. Administrator for Middle Schools, Corina Ramirez. And of course, me, Administrator for Elementary School, Diana Ruiz. I'm on the list. Other dignitaries present here today with us, we have City of Far Mayor, Leopoldo Polo Palacios, Jr. Mayor Pro Term, Adan Farias. Commissioner Arturo J. Cortez and Commissioner Eduardo Cantu. City of San Juan members, we have Mayor Pro Term Armando Garza Jr., City of San Juan, and Commissioner Eddie Suarez. U.S. Commissioner Hector Palacios, Hidalgo County. We also have former Superintendent Arturo Guajardo. He's here today. We have principals and directors, just please stand up, please, so that you can be recognized. Any principals or directors that are here today? And we have UTPA representative Yvette Padilla with us also today. If I hope I didn't leave anybody out. If I did, anybody out, sir? The mayor of San Juan? Is he here with us today? Ernesto Alvarado, I'm sorry. Ernesto. Okay, we appreciate everybody's presence here, and this seems like a reunion for Mrs. Escobar because we see a lot of people that she has worked with before, and please enjoy this today. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Reese. And now I'd like to call up to the microphone the first principal for the Aida Escobar School. No pressure. Ms. Nava? Like to call her up here.
Good morning. Welcome to our beautiful campus. I am Leticia Nava, first principal, and it is an honor and a privilege to be the first principal of this beautiful facility. First and foremost, I'd like to thank God for empowering the leaders of this district with the vision to build this school. I would also like to thank the community members who voted for the bond issue that made it possible for us to acquire the funds to build this school. A special thank you to all of our staff members who assisted in preparing for this beautiful event. A sincere thank you to the Public Relations Maintenance Department for preparing and planning for this beautiful day. Last but not least, thank you to our school board members for dedicating this campus in honor of a proven and successful educator, Aida C. Escobar. On behalf of our students and staff members, thank you for attending this dedication today, and may God bless you.
Thank you, Ms. Nava. And Aida, as you can see with all the special guests, and now you, principal here, all the students here, you know, we brought all the big guns out, you know, just to salute you. And speaking of big guns, I'd like now to call on the superintendent of schools, Dr. Daniel King, to give us the welcome.
Good morning. Thank you for coming. What an honor, what an honor for Aida Escobar, but really I want to say what an honor for all of us, for this district to be honored with your name on this school. I've been here, this is my sixth year in the district, but I can tell you that long before I came to PSJA, I was very familiar with the work of Aida Escobar. As I worked in neighboring districts of Hidalgo and Mission, back when she was a principal and as assistant superintendent for curriculum, you always knew that when top achieving schools were going to be announced, you always knew that whatever school or schools that Aida Escobar was, was in charge of, were going to be at the top of the list. And this, it's a real tribute. It's sort of a challenge, I guess, Ms. Nava and the students and the staff here, that I'm sure that Ms. Escobar is going to expect the school named after her to always be there at the top of the list. But like I said, what an honor, and thank you for honoring us with your presence and your family, your husband. I was looking, 43 years, Richard, is a long time to give the district and the community the labor and sacrifice of your wife. I also want to thank, I want to mention also all of our school board members, very important. Also, Mr. Raymond Gonzalez asked me to send you a special, you know, note that health reasons have not allowed him to be here this morning, but he's looked forward very much to being here today, and he's here certainly in his presence, and I know some of our other school board members also that work or things did not allow them to be here. But really want to thank everyone so much. You know, really want to thank the board for their leadership. PSJ is really probably in the last, probably two-thirds of the way through a really remarkable, you know, initiative to really rebuild the entire district. This year, this campus is one of six brand new campuses opened this school year. And that's, you know, there's no other district around that's undertaking such an aggressive plan of rebuilding all the facilities, remodeling, renovating, and that's due to the leadership of the board. And even more, I want to thank the community, because without the support of the leaders of our three cities, our three fine cities that we work with, and then of course without the support of the voters and community members who have come out and voted to support these bonds, really just keeping in mind the vision, for example, here today of Aida Escobar, to always give our children, the children of this community, to give them the best. To give them the best. They're the future of this community, and we want to give them the best of our, you know, in facilities, the best learning environment, the best classrooms. Of course, more important, we want the best teachers possible to be teaching our children. We want the best principals to be leading them and working all together. So really want to thank, this is a beautiful, beautiful facility, you know, specially designed for the children of this community. But I want to thank everyone. PSJ has, you know, a long-standing history and tradition of excellence in many areas. And our goal, you know, our job is to keep on building on what's been done in the past and you know, honor the past but point to the future and keep moving forward. And so thanks to, you know, many of the former leaders here of the district and the community that are here also, and then the current leaders. And then I look up there in the bleachers on either side of you, and I see the leaders of tomorrow. And that's what we're all here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. King. Very well said. I also would like to call up to the podium the school board president, Mr. Ronnie Cantu, for also some special remarks.
Good morning. I kind of had asked Dr. King if I could go first because I knew he was going to take all my words, and I'd probably have to stand up here and say ditto, but he did a great job, and I'm honored to be here today to honor Ms. Aida Escobar, who I'm very close to and have known for a very long time, and I'm honored to be able to come up here and speak for her and for this wonderful school that has been dedicated to her. It's a gorgeous, beautiful facility, and I hope you all get a chance to walk it later. But I'm so glad to be here, and it's interesting that we come from an older school that honored a pioneer from our history past, Eli Whitney, who was a pioneer in the cotton gin and the farming industry, and really developed something that was new at the time, but revolutionized our history when it was first started. And now the history that you have provided, PSJA, has led us to this point, and it's an honor to have your name on this place for our future children, for our future leaders of PSJA or the community. We're so proud to have you on the name of this building as part of the legacy here at PSJA and all the hard work and dedication that you put into the school. I don't think there's anybody out there that has worked as hard as you have, and if they have, I honor you too. But today it's your day, it's a beautiful day, and I just want to say that I'm so grateful for everything that you have done. And usually it takes a committee, most of the time it takes a committee to name a school, but this one was a slam dunk. It was you all the way. You deserve it so much, and we're so glad to have you. Thank you so much. Thank you.